And Lord, in your house.
Yes.
We thank you, Lord, for a place that we can come to hear your word, Lord.
Yes.
We ask, Lord, that you bring forth your word tonight, Lord. That you bless your manservant with wisdom, Lord. That you be here by your spirit, Lord.
Yes.
That you bring forth, Lord, who you are, Lord, and what it is to be a pleasure to you.
Yes.
Father, minister unto the hearts and minds of your people, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we ask and pray.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Everything's set up. Let's put on the set up. I come to bring an enlightenment of the Word of God. How many of you smoke in here? How many drink in here? How many know that your old life, you don't do the same things you used to do?
Amen.
I want to, and I can thank God for giving me clarification of His Word. Because without His Word, we'd be lost.
Amen.
We've shown up work. Oh, my Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I want to talk to you tonight about coming to perfection. Coming to perfection. How many of you here believe that you cannot be perfect? Okay. Where would you believe that you can't be perfect? This is Bible study, so you can go ahead and talk. This ain't Sunday, but you can just... Hey! Because temptation exists? That don't mean nothing. That don't mean nothing. I hear you. You don't think so either? Okay, let's see what the Word of God says. Now, I want to share this with you. I want to share this with you. Remember, this isn't my Word. Okay? Alright? And I want you to understand that the Word of God, hear me, God sends His Word to bless you.
Amen.
If God speaks against, if He speaks against an attribute, hear me, and you're not doing it, but the thought comes to your mind to do it, you're not wrong. I want you to hear me. I want you to hear me very closely. If a cigarette comes to my mind, and I know I don't want to smoke no cigarette, and I say, ugh, am I wrong?
No.
Huh?
No.
Am I wrong?
No.
Why? Why? I didn't enact it. See, we're living by what we think. Are you hearing? Now listen, I'm gonna show you this, okay? All right. Praise the Lord. Now I want you to understand, perfection is when you come to the point of complete. Now, I want you to answer me this question. When you have a dress and it fits you well, what do you say? You look what? Beautiful. Why? Why? No, not because you. No, hold on a minute now. No, don't be scatterbrained. Let's go back to chapter 1, all right? Don't go to 9, all right? That's the reason why you have a hard time believing that you can't come to perfection. Because you're scatterbrained. You know what I'm saying? But let me bring this to light. we give ourselves credit to the natural, hear me, that car suits me perfect. That house will suit me perfect. That hat fit me perfect. Huh? Those shoes fit me perfect. But when it comes down to us living right, we ain't perfect. Huh? Let me explain to you. And I got something for you. You know, I got something for all of y'all. Because I want you to hear me very closely. You need to stop robbing yourself and putting yourself in the bottom of the barrel.
Amen.
When you listen to the enemy and he tells you you ain't good enough, you're forever going to feel never good enough. It's time for us to get out of that stupidity, y'all.
Amen.
It's time for us to come to the knowledge of the truth of Christ Jesus.
Amen.
It is.
Amen.
You go to a job and do exactly what the boss says, you're a perfect employee.
Amen.
And some employees win Employee of the Month.
Amen.
Why? Because that month they did everything perfect. Why are we going to go on ahead and allow ourselves to, on a natural sense, we reach perfection, but yet we think on a spiritual sense we can't ever reach perfection? Well, let me explain to you what the word perfect means. All right? Perfection means the condition or state or quality of being free. Now, let me ask you a question. How many of you still smoke? Oh, I take it back. Thank you, Father. How many of you in here used to smoke cigarettes? Huh? Okay. Put your hand down. How many of you stopped smoking cigarettes? You perfect. You perfected that part.
Amen.
How many of you used to drink? How many of you don't drink? Huh? You perfected that part. Perfection means you're free from that. Or as free as possible from the flaws or defects. That's what perfection means. It means the condition or state or quality of being free. Being free means you're no more bound to that. You don't do it no more. I don't care what you think. You don't do it no more.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
Are you hearing this?
Amen.
Are you hearing this?
Amen.
See, when we're too quick to judge ourselves wrong, we'll judge everybody else wrong too.
Amen.
You're not giving yourself the ability to come to the full change like you had that desire within you to have. Because you're too busy judging yourself wrong. You're not giving, you know, you give sin a whole heap of avenue. But when it comes down to you having your part, your chance, and also your life to be converted and changed and absolutely shown to be in a different mindset and a different light and in a different response, you cut yourself short because you said it can't be reached. Well, how do you give yourself place to perfect this but not that? Does that make sense? That don't make no sense. It's okay to eat food, but you can't drink juice. You need the juice. Are you hearing me? Somebody says, what? In other words, they go hand in hand. If you can perfect on the natural, you definitely can perfect it on the spiritual. Are you hearing me? Because it first becomes spiritual, then it becomes natural. Because you got to think it in order to do it. You got to think it in order to do it. So if your heart is saying, no, I don't want to, but a thought comes into your mind to say you should, or you know you want to, and your heart says, I don't want to, you perfected that part about you.
Amen.
Did you think? Now, I got something for that, too. I got something for that. Hold your hands, sweetie. Hold your hands. I got something for that. Because let me tell you something. God was, the Father was bringing this to my attention. When you beat yourself up, there won't be room for growth. Let me share this with y'all, saints of God. I'm learning. God is teaching me how to minister. He's teaching me how to encourage. And he's also teaching me how to bring forth the word of God. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? I want you to understand that everything that you need is going to be in the Word of God.
Amen.
Now, because it's in the Word of God, the only one who we can really trust is Jesus.
Amen.
You can't trust how you feel.
Amen.
Because your feelings come and go, but the Word of God stays the same.
Amen.
Are you hearing this? Check this out now. Perfection is the action or process of improving. The action, the doings of improving. So you don't smoke no more, but you used to smoke. So you came to the knowledge that smoking won't do you any good. Are you hearing me? So what happens? What happens? You quit. Y'all looking at me like, what? Are y'all with me?
Amen.
Or is this too good for y'all? Is this unbelievable for y'all? Huh? Pastor, you're teaching something that we can't never get to. Who told you that?
Amen.
Who told you that? Huh? Listen. Perfection means the action or process of improving something until it's flawless. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
Philippians 2. Quickly, hurry up now. Hebrews 13, Philippians 2, quickly, hurry up now, Philippians, chapter 2,
amen,
okay, now, I'm going to tell you what the word says, okay, I ain't making this up now, okay, I ain't fabricating it. Right? How many believe the word of God?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
How many believe the word of God in here?
Amen.
How many believe what God is saying?
Amen.
How many believe what he's saying in his word? How many
Amen.
Believe what he's saying in his word? Okay, let's look at his word. Philippians chapter 2, verse 12.
Amen.
Huh? Read.
Wherefore, God beloved,
uh-huh.
And ye have always obeyed.
When?
Not as in my presence only,
but
much more in my absence.
What did he say?
Work out your own salvation.
In other words, perfect your walk. Perfect your new life. Perfection means the action or the process. Process don't mean you got there yet. Process means that you're on your way. The process of improving something until it's flawless. Without blemish.
No.
Are you hearing
me?
No. You're improving something.
Amen.
What are you improving? Your mind. God is improving your mind. Because when God captivates your mind, he'll have your and love them at the same time. You can't do that. You cannot do that. You can't be so, oh, I'm scared to God, but I love him. No, no. You can't fear and love at the same time. You can reverence and respect and honor and love at the same time, but you can't boogeyman fear and love at the same time, because fear has torment. Fear has torment. Are you hearing this? I want you to understand that you cannot at all do and live after the Lord or do what he said if you don't have an awareness of where he brought you from. If you focus on the negative, you'll always think negative, and you'll never come onto the state of being positive. You'll always wallow in the what ifs and how comes and why can I and all of these different dumb things. Are you hearing me? Let me show you something. Let me show you something. Okay? Let me show you something. Hebrews. 13. All right? I'm going to show you something. Hebrews 13 chapter. All right? Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Amen. Amen. God said to work out your own salvation. In other words, while we're at that juncture, here. You cannot at all. God is saying that you cannot look at somebody else and judge them. Hear this. The reason why God said you can't look at somebody else and judge them, because you got a mote. In other words, you got something that you know you need to work on. So you can't look at somebody else's fault and find accusation on what they're not doing, because you should be too busy looking upon the things that you need to work on.
Amen.
Are you hearing what the Word of God is saying? I'll show you exactly where it's at. If you need proof. He said, how could you tell your brother, let me get the beam out your eye and you got a smoke on yours? Let me help you with that. You can't afford to do that. Because that is a trait of Satan. That's a trait of the enemy. To always find fault in somebody else. That's how the enemy brings division. That's how he divides and conquers. That's how he divides and conquers. Are you hearing this? Hebrews 13, 20, and 21.
Now the God of peace that brought again from the dead.
Now hold on a minute. The God of who?
Peace.
Who?
The God of peace.
Oh, okay. What did he do?
That brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus.
He brought again. In other words, he was there one time, and he did it for him again. Are you hearing me? He was in flesh. And he was in the grave. Brought him up again from the dead. Go ahead.
That great shepherd of the sheep.
Yes.
Through the blood of the everlasting covenant.
Through the blood, through the word of promise. Now I want you to hear this. Everlasting covenant means that God promised you his word.
Amen.
The word that he gives you, hello, hello,
yes.
Hello, the word that he's giving you right now,
Amen.
He said, this is my promise to you.
Amen.
This is what I said was going to do for you.
Yes.
Are you hearing this?
Amen.
Listen to what he said he was going to do. Read.
Make you perfect.
God what?
Make you perfect.
God what?
Make you perfect.
He going to make you what?
Perfect.
Is he a man that he's alive?
Hallelujah.
Huh? He going to make you what?
Perfect.
Perfect. Is he a liar? Are you hearing this? How? 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 Listen. Listen. In what?
In every good
in
work.
In every area of your life, God said he going to perfect it.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Are you hearing this?
Amen.
God's going to revamp your mind.
Hallelujah.
He's going to recreate how you take things in.
Amen.
He's going to recreate how you view people. Oh, you need to hear. Some of y'all looking like, that's impossible. You're impossible. Don't rob me from getting blessed. Because you don't want to believe. Don't hit that on me. I didn't come to Christ to be bound.
Amen.
I did not come from bondage and be suppressed and literally have a wallowing mindset of depression to come to Christ and be depressed too.
Amen.
He said, who the Son is set free is free indeed. I'm so not free. Hallelujah. You need to make it up in your mind and tell yourself, I didn't come from bondage to be in bondage.
Right.
Oh, no. But then I might as well stay up there.
Hallelujah.
No way. That devil is a liar. And I'm going to cut his throat.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to hear me now. I want you to hear me. I see your hand. But listen to what he said now. I want you to hear what the Word of God said he was going to do for you specifically. You can't put nobody else in that bubble. It's only you and God. And there ain't nobody else. It's me and God, not me, God, and my wife. No, no, no. It's me and God. It's me and God. Not me, God, my wife, my kids, my aunt, my uncle. No, it's me and God. It's God and my wife. It's God and my kids.
Yes.
Hear me.
Yes.
It's the Lord and I. My walk is not hinged upon somebody else.
Amen.
So no, I want you to hear what the Lord has dumped into my spirit. I want you to hear me delivering word. God is moving us up, y'all.
Amen.
I'm telling you this right now. God is moving us up.
Amen.
He's moving us up in understanding of his word and coming to the completeness of faith and everything else, in power, in wisdom, in knowledge, in every single area of our life. God is moving us up.
Amen.
And I'm going right along with
him.
Amen. Who on God's side? Lift your hand. Who on God's side? Lift your hand. Praise God. I hope you is on God's side. You better be. Do not be on God's side and die. Oh, Lord. Jesus, help me. Hebrews, read.
Through the blood of the everlasting covenant.
He's going to make you perfect in what?
Make you perfect.
Uh-huh.
In every good work.
In every good work to what?
To do his will.
In other words, he's converting our minds to be sold out to him.
Amen.
Woo, I'm excited. Do it for me, Lord. Right now.
Hallelujah.
Give me me. I'm tired of doubting. I'm tired of saying that I can't. And I know it's something in me is saying that I can't. God tell me, sweet nothing. Some of you make it.
Amen.
Just because he know he ain't gonna make it, don't put me in your shoes, brother. Change your mind. go on ahead and let me follow the Spirit of the Lord. Go to John. Go to John. Go to John. Quick. Hurry up now. Hurry up. Hurry up now. How do you think you got to having the ability of overcoming things? John 15. John 15. When you get there, say amen. Amen. Verse 5. Amen?
Amen.
Read, brother.
I am the vine.
I am the vine.
Ye are the branches.
And are you hearing this? Are you hearing how we're in him? We're in him. We're in him. The branches don't just go on ahead and just fall all over the ground and all that. Are you hearing me? The branches are still connected to the source. No matter how low they sink in life, they're still connected to Jesus.
Amen.
I am the vine. And who's the branches? Me. Go ahead.
He that abideth in me.
He that what?
Abideth in me.
Go ahead.
And I in him.
Go ahead.
The same bringeth forth much fruit.
The same. Now I want you to hear this now. I want you to hear the fruit that you've got. Hear me. You got power over smoking. Power over drinking. Power over cursing. Power over depression. Power over anger. Think about the dungeons that you were in. Are you kidding me? Think of the dungeons that you were in. Listen to what he says now. Listen to what he says. Come on and read.
The same bringeth forth much fruit.
The same bringeth forth much fruit now.
For without me.
For who?
Without me.
For without who?
Jesus.
Without who? Read.
Ye can do nothing.
He said, without who? Me.
Me.
Without who?
Me.
Without who?
Me.
Without who?
Me.
You can do what?
Nothing.
You can't do nothing. Go back. Hebrews 13:21. God is saying without him, you couldn't have been where you're at right now.
Amen.
You couldn't have stopped smoking, stopped drinking, stopped clubbing, amen, stopped hanging out and all that. You needed God. It was amen. God all the time.
Amen.
What did he say he was going to do? Make you what?
Perfect.
Make you perfect. Boy, I get me excited, y'all. You don't know how to get excited. Come to Jesus. See, you're trusting in your ability. You're not putting your faith in the Word of God. You're trusting in how you would do things. That's why if it feels like you can't meet up to it, you can never be perfect. Because you think you can do it. Well, what's the sense of relying on Jesus? What's the sense of waiting on Christ? What's the sense of being his servant? What's the sense of trusting? If you think you can do it on your own, you don't need a God. I need him.
Amen.
There are times in my life where I feel impatient. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And the reason why I call on him, because I know I'm not wrestling against another individual. I'm wrestling against my flesh trying to tell me that you need to go on ahead and punch this dude in his mouth. So, no, no, that's not me no more. I'm not a thug no more.
Amen.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I got to hide.
Yes.
My outlet is Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Because
I know he made a way last time when I wanted to punch whatchamacallit in his brain. He'll do it again.
Amen.
you warn your brothers of the righteousness. Go ahead. If you and I are hanging out together, this is how you warn your brother of the righteousness. Let me cut it short. So y'all don't want to start having these different answers. Hold your hand. You and I are hanging out together, right? And somebody takes $5 from me. You understand what I'm saying? And now I want to physically put my hands on them. You're with me. You should tell me, brother, it ain't even worth you doing that. You understand what I'm saying? That's how you warn your brethren of the righteousness. You don't quote words. You know the Bible says anger, but say not. You over here getting, and you acting like, don't do that. Why would you kick somebody when they're done? Of their righteousness. You don't come to them quoting scriptures and beating them up and telling them, look how you look, you look so ugly, acting like that. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. I thought you had more power than that. You don't do that to them. What if you was in that condition and somebody came busting you upside your head with words? Huh? Oh, you get so tight. You get so mad. Pastor. The nerve. I don't want to hear that. Right? I just want to ask you a question. Am I right or wrong? You wrong. Period. Don't ask me the question. Are you hearing me? We need to do it exactly how the Word of God says. I'm learning, y'all. Go ahead, Brother Eric. Some people think that if they come to the church, the whole building will fall down. First of all, you ain't the enemy, period. Let's get that straight. Second of all, he comes to the church all the time. You know what I'm saying? He comes to church all the time. Now, hear me. When people talk, and I love when people talk like that, well, if I get up in there, you know what I'm saying? Yo, the angels might lose their wings, man. You stupid, sad sack individual, big dummy, you. Are you hearing me? God said that he was going to make you perfect in every good work. To do his will, not your will, his will. And the reason why he's going to make you perfect is because you're going to come to the understanding, wait a second, I don't want to do this no more. When you get to that point, all he's working in you. Are you? Hallelujah. Glory be to God. He's doing a shift of rule in you. Are you hearing this? He's causing you to think hard on the time that you wasted based upon how you felt. And making you come to the acknowledgement that this ain't even worth me reacting on a negative sense for, because it's still the same and I ain't changing. I need somebody that can get inside the whole entire scenario and change things for me.
Yes.
But I need to hold my peace and let the Lord fight my battle. I'm talking about we're coming to perfection, y'all. Listen, perfection means the action or the process of improving something until it's flawless. It means a betterment, and it means a refinement. Are you hearing this? Verse 21.
Make you perfect.
Make you perfect. Where?
In every good work.
In every good work.
To do his will. Working in you.
He's working in you. That.
That which is well pleasing.
Are you in whose sight?
In his sight.
In other words, God is saying, stop smoking. You're wasting your time.
Amen.
You make your mind up and stop smoking. You're working that which is pleasing in his sight. Thank God. Woo! I thank God beat. Get tired of getting beat. I need to be encouraged. I need to be strengthened. I need to be uplifted. I can't be doing all that stuff and I got weight up on me. Oh, no, get off of me. In the name of Jesus. I want you to hear what the Holy Ghost is saying. The enemy came bringing word of discouragement, using the word of God to pound down Christ. But Christ came, he said, listen, get behind me. For God and God alone you shall serve. Are you hearing this? Jesus, I'll never forget. Now, why would you never forget what he done for you, but yet you feel sad? Because you feel you can't lead up to it. Huh? How you set me free? And then I'm bound on Tuesday. And I get a feeling of feeling good, and I'm free. What you living by? Drop that flesh. Let it go.
Let it go.
Let it go. It ain't working.
Amen.
We need to try Jesus' way.
Amen.
Listen to what he said. He said, work. Oh, I love it when he said, hallelujah, glory be to his wonderful name. Oh, I get excited when he said, he working in you.
Yes.
Feel it in my hands. Thank you, that's the higher glory. I feel it in my feet. I feel him all over me. All over me. When he's in my heart, he's all over me. All over me. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Oh, my hair is standing up. Bless the wonderful name of Jesus. Father, he's the one that's pushing you. to greatness. He's the one that knows what timidness is inside of you. He's telling you, speak my word, and my word will overcome that feeling. He said, I'll show you my faith by my words. Matthew 19. Hurry up quickly. pertaining to you coming to perfection. And Jesus spoke about it the whole entire way. I want you to hear this now. I want you to hear this now. Matthews. Amen. 5. You have it?
Amen.
Verse 48. What did he say? Huh?
Be ye therefore perfect.
Whoa. We understand that if I live based upon how I feel, I'll never come to perfection. But if I drop how I feel and come to the awareness that this life is not good for me because I never have stability in this thinking. But if I pick up the word of God, pick Jesus up, and put him in my heart and say, Lord, I trust you. Even when feelings of discouragement try to come, I trust you, Lord. I know that if I stay walking by faith and not by sight, the just, those that are holy, are going to live by faith and not by sight. Our lifestyle is going to be by faith and not by sight. Because if you see things, you'll be swayed away. Yes. Yes. Say that again. Right. Yes. Right. Right. I'm so glad you said that. You can't? God said, right. But then again, see, we're living by principalities. Spirits. Rulers. Do you understand what I'm saying? No. I got that too. Nobody, my friend. You know what I'm saying? Ephesians 6. Hurry up now. Follow me, y'all. Please, follow me. Ephesians 6, y'all. Ephesians 6.
Amen.
We ain't wrestling against another individual.
Amen. That's right.
Ephesians 6, 12. Hurry up now. There's a part in the script where he says, wait on the Lord. Then again, I say, wait. Why? Because he knows you're going to try to be impatient. He knows your flesh is going to try to make you feel impatient. Read.
For we what? Wrestle not.
Against what?
Against flesh and blood.
You're not wrestling against people. It's spirits that are trying to tell you or put in your mind or make you view somebody else in a negative form. It's a spirit that will talk to your conscience and tell you, you'll never meet up to God's expectation. Look at them. I want to ask you this question. I want you to hear what the Holy Ghost is saying. Do you want to think that way? I'm asking you, Father Lee. Do you want to think that way? Yeah. Be honest. Okay. You don't know. Good. And the reason why you don't know is because, truth be told, you really don't want no problems. How many want problems in here? You want problems? Oh, so you don't want to really think that way. But because we've gotten accustomed to living how we feel, if our feelings get attacked, our response is to protect our feelings. So now what happens is we don't know how to let go of our feelings, but because we've been so used to trusting in how we feel for that to be the absolute truth. Are you hearing this? So now God is saying how you feel, that's not really you. Are you hearing me? He's saying that's principalities. Read, we wrestle not against what?
Flesh and blood.
But against what?
But against principalities.
Against what?
Against powers.
Uh-huh.
Against the rulers of darkness.
Powers. You know what powers is? Like Ghana. You know what I'm talking about? When you get that feeling, that's powers. That's the swaying of the flesh wanting you to perform. Are you hearing me? And James, he said that, listen, we get swayed away. Hear me? We get swayed away. We get enticed. And when we get enticed, the enticement, when it's fulfilled, it bringeth forth death. And death, when it is finished, it bringeth forth sin. And sin, when it is finished, either or, because either or, it's in violation. And God is saying, I don't want you to live by how you feel, because your flesh, he said in the book of Romans, he said, I know that is to say, in my flesh dwells no good feeling. Are you hearing me? So if you live based upon how you feel, then you're already in a losing battle before you get to the battle.
Amen. Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Amen.
You won't have the sword of the sword of the spirit and the helmet of salvation and the shield of faith and all that. You won't have that. Because you'll already be defeated, because you'll already be convinced that you can't do it and you're not be able to make it. But it's not by power nor by might, but God's saying it's by my spirit.
Yes,
are you hearing this? In other words, it's not by how you feel, it's by my word. God is saying it's not how you feel. It's not what comes to try to make you come to the awareness that you're never no good, or you'll never come to the completeness of God's pleasure. It's not by that feeling. It's by my word. Listen to what God told me. He said, listen, he said, timidness is still keeping that mind around. Paul said, I can do all things, overcoming those principalities. When you're timid, hear me. Timid, I'm going to show you something. Yes, go ahead. Wait on God. Right. You got to wait on God. Don't do it. Don't. Listen, don't ever do nothing how you feel. Don't do it. You know how many things touch me in my mind. I feel like doing something. Ooh. You hear me? I can't do what I feel. Then if I did what I feel, oh, smokes. I ain't gonna be no pastor. I'm be in jail. Something. Dead. Somewhere. Quit back in a hurry. But man, I'm gonna fight sometime. What? And I be wanting to knock somebody out just to show them. This is how I used to do it, y'all. Bye out. You know why I can't do it? Because I love him. I think back and think in my mind, should I bust into the white meat? I don't want to do it because I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. You understand what I'm saying? I don't want to be with the other woman. I don't want to hang out with them. I don't want to go clubbing. I don't want to go put this and that. I don't want to do that no more. Because I love them. Are you hearing me? You got to come to the understanding, it's not even worth you reacting to how you feel. It ain't even worth it. You know why? Tell me what good thing you've gotten out of how you felt. You tell me one good thing. Yeah, one good thing that has benefited your life. That has benefited your life. That has made you prosper. Because you did what you feel. On the negative. Nothing. There ain't nothing. If I respond to how I feel on the negative, I'm not winning.
Wow.
No. Well, that's cool. You don't know if it's negative? Well, if you don't know if it's negative, I won't even act like it's positive. Because positive is when you give a little kid a sucker. Here you go. You know what I'm saying? Or you give them a cracker. Negative is when you give somebody. Do you understand what I'm saying?
we'll talk later. Oh, yeah, you talk to Sister Samaria. Go ahead, you do that. You know what I'm saying? Knock yourself out. Timidness. Timidness is you're lacking in self-assurance. This is where the people of God are. When you're timid, you're lacking in self-assurance. You're lacking in courage. You're lacking in bravery.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? You're easily alarmed. Easily alarmed. Oh, man. Are you hearing me? Like you get scared all the time for no reason at all. That's like saying, yo, go put gas in the car. Man, I'm scared that thing gonna blow up, man. The fuse is gonna. Come on, man. Scared to do simple things in Christ. Scared to keep the simple things in Christ. And guess what? Everything about him is simple.
Amen.
Because he made it plain.
Amen.
For you. You know why? He said that a fool would not err in him doing what he said. He said timidness is when you're shy to do things that you're supposed to do. Go ahead, no. Go ahead, man. Stop acting like that. You know, remember when we had the run? Remember when we had the run at the park? And you guys are tearing a dozen eggs up left and right. Remember? How many of you remember the run? Huh? The run. Yeah, some of y'all looking like y'all. This y'all first day in this church. The run, y'all remember? The run with the spoon and the egg? Remember? Huh? Somebody goes, I want to join, I want to join. And when it's their turn, they're like, no, I don't want to go. What you going to say? Go! Remember? No, we're losing because of you. Right? Remember? Everybody was yelling. You would have thought something bad happened over there. Everybody in deliberate word hollering. Somebody could have stole our food. Because everybody was yelling. Kids are taking grapes, shooting them. We yelling, come on, go! They're like, oh, okay, I'll keep on. We sweeping up chips and all that. Huh? Am I right, saints?
Amen.
You shy. Move forward in God. Now, I'm going to start picking on y'all now. Quiet is time for you to sing. I can't do it. Musicians, scared to play. You bunch of scary boogers. Y'all looking at each other? shot. Come on! Pray, King, you're told not to go on ahead and sing praise songs, and then you kill the whole entire mood. The Spirit of God said, you call me when you want to go ahead and move.
Wanna be great?
Come on, man! No, it ain't great. It's dead, man. Everybody go from Hallelujah. Don't nobody want that. You're demonstrating fear.
Amen.
I can't do that, Pastor. You need to stop that.
Amen.
You're telling yourself a lie. Amen. Apostle Paul said, I can
do all things.
Through who? Through
Christ,
not through my ability, through His strength. His strength, His empowerment. You trust too much in your strength, and you ain't got no strength. Craig? pillow, in my pillow. Oh, you're going to be sleeping on the pillow, all right. The little pillow that's in the coffin. And it's going to be comfortable for you because you ain't going to tell the difference. Your body going to automatically go into a lockdown. That's exactly how you're going to stay. Are you hearing me? Y'all looking like I'm crazy. I ain't crazy. You crazy. Ephesians 6. Listen, hold on a minute now. First John. Hurry up, man. Hurry up. Hurry up, man. Time flies when you're having fun in the Lord. First John. Hurry up, man. Hurry up. First John 4. I want you to hear about timidness. Huh? Amen. First John 4. Verse 18. Read.
There is no fear in love.
There's no what?
Fear.
In what?
In love.
In here, you can't come to perfection. You all wrapped up in fear and timidness, and you shy and you scared, and you don't want to do it. There ain't no heart in you to move forward over that. You talking about something? Hey, every time I come to this wall. No, no. The wall is really the point where you have to say, I'm tired of you, and keep it moving. It ain't a wall, it's an overcoming. He ain't never said anything about no wall. Except that they go on ahead and praise God. And the wall of Jericho, what did it do? Came down. Why? Because what did they do? They praised God. So when your challenges come down, when will that challenge, that obstacle that you say you always run into, is going to come down? Because you got to reach perfection. In reaching perfection, you got to learn to get rid of rejection. You got to get rid of it. First John 4, 18, read.
There is no fear in love.
There ain't no fear in love. Why?
But perfect love.
But perfect what?
Love.
Perfect what?
Love.
I want you to see this now because, hold on a minute. Okay. Perfect love, what does it do?
Cast it out fear.
It what?
Cast it out.
It cast out fear. Perfect love casts out fear. Colossians chapter 3. Hurry up. Remember, perfect love casts out fear. Colossians 3. Hurry up. Hurry up. Hurry up. Hurry up, y'all. Colossians, third chapter. You got it? 14th verse. Read.
And above all these things.
And above all these things, what happened?
Put on charity.
Put on love. For it is what?
The bond of perfectness.
Now, the bond means, listen, it is the unity. Listen, it's the uniting principle. It's the control. Love is the control of perfection. Love keeps you in perfection. Oh, not beating yourself down.
Hallelujah.
Love keeps you in perfection. Read that again.
And above all these things.
Above all these things that he's talking about.
Put on charity.
He said put on love.
Which is the bond of perfectness.
Now, God is saying, I want you to understand the, not secret, but the format of perfection. The format of perfection is brought to light by charity. Charity. How many love Jesus in here?
Amen.
And you can't come to perfection? The word of God says different.
Amen.
He said if you put on love, that's the bond of perfection. action. Then he said that, what did he say in 1 John chapter 4? He said, you love, there's no fear in love. For love, perfect love, casts out fear. Are you hearing this? Because fear has torment. I want you to hear what the word torment is. It's called penal infliction. Penal infliction. And penal means that it's involving punishment as for crimes or offenses. You're timid because you feel you broke the law of God. I feel like I'm not holy. Like I'm not. I know I want to do everything that's right to get right and to do right, but I just feel like as if this, I just, the explanation is, I just feel like it's just, I can't really get there. Who told you that?
Amen.
Timidness. And in timidness, it's indicating that you have fear.
Amen.
And fear is torment. And torment means that you're living by the law. Because you feel like you're out of the realm of pleasure. Are you hearing this?
Amen.
So you walk on eggshells. You walk with a condemned mind. You live by a condemned mind. You are not free to enjoy Christ.
Amen.
This is not enjoying Christ. When you have fluctuatings throughout the week.
Amen. That's not enjoying Christ. Amen.
Listen, perfection is when the state or quality of being free. When you know you're free on something, why would you condemn yourself like as if you're guilty? Like as if you just did it. Unless you did do it, that repentance has to happen again. Hear me. Love keeps you in the realm of pleasure. Are you hearing this? Listen to what he says now. Listen to what he says. Because torment is fear. And see, when fear is around, growth is not there at all. When fear is around, I want you to see this now. Did you finish reading that?
No.
Go ahead.
He that feareth is not made perfect in love.
Oh, are you seeing this? Am I talking to the wall?
Amen.
Am I? He that feareth. Are you kidding me? I'm talking to this plastic. He that feareth is not made perfect at all. Do y'all want to be saved?
Amen.
Do y'all want to come to the knowledge of the truth?
Amen.
Here it is! Oh, I'm excited. Am I the only one excited about receiving this? Well, you got to be a pastor to be excited? Like, hey. Read that again.
He that feareth is not made perfect.
He that is tormented, he that's walking by the law is not made perfect. In love. Are you hearing this?
Amen.
So if you live by the law, you know what the Lord said to me? Let me tell you what the Lord said to me. Ooh, it's three pages of this. You hear me? He said the Pharisees was lax to the law. And they always spoke about what the law. Jesus was latched to the heart. I got scripture to back it up. You hear me? The Pharisees were latched to the law. Soon as they see somebody doing wrong, they always accuse it. Well, when you're in fear, you're always judging somebody else. Because you're in the realm of judging negative about you. So quite naturally, you're going to automatically judge everybody else on the negative. Because you don't see any possibility of you being in the realm of pleasure. Because you're tormented. And torment is when you get stripped from being who you are to be. Oh, you need to hear what the Holy Ghost is talking about. This is too intelligent for a ninth grader to come up with. You need to think about those times. Huh? When you thought you was bound. And you were really free. But because you listened on how you felt, you put yourself back into bondage. And it's like you were wrestling to get out of something that you were never really in no more. Because you got told, swayed by way of feeling, you honestly thought within yourself that you really didn't go ahead and accomplish that mode or that method, or should I say what we call that trouble, that trial. And God said, I've already made you free from that. Because your flesh tell you you ain't good enough. Oh, see, you done did it again. Oops, I did it again. I played with your heart. And I messed up. Come on, man. Are you hearing me? And I sing that song because you got the somebody done done me wrong song. Let it go.
Let it go.
God is bringing you to a perfection. And when you get brought to perfection, there's some things that you just got to let go and don't even pay no mind to. You got to learn to stop listening. You got to cover your ear to your flesh. Stop listening to how you feel. You're really listening to a lie. Are you hearing this? Listen to what he said. Read that again. Read that again.
There is no love. There is no fear in
there
love.
There ain't no fear in love. You make me want to say, cuz. There ain't no fear in it. Remember God said earlier, you can't fear and love at the same time. Are you here? Timidness. Fear. Scared to move forward in life. I'm not talking about moving forward in life financially. I'm talking about moving forward in life in Christ. Not in your ability. Because you ain't got no ability. Hey, listen. Even when you were in sin, you didn't even have your own ability either because you were led by every other spirit. So you never really did anything of your own. Woo! Huh? The only time you ever had choice is when you said, okay, yeah, anyways. We were like spiritual prostitutes. Getting used by whatever spirit we've allowed for it to rape us of our lives. Sure enough, we were impregnated with evil thoughts, impregnated with evil demeanors, impregnated with evil surmisings, evil devices and evil ways and all that. We were impregnated in all that with complexes, impregnated with fear, impregnated with being shy, impregnated of you can't be able to reach or meet or accomplish or complete. Impregnated. Because every spirit left the sperm seed of doubt all the time. And you never miscarried. You birthed out every last one of them. We birthed out every last one of them. But Jesus came to do a genocide. You know when a lion of the tribe of Judah, when a lion comes to go on ahead and mate with another with the female one, he first has to kill. After he kills the father, he kills the babies. Are you hearing this? Look it up in National Geographic, y'all. He kills the baby that comes, because the existence of that child and that other lion in that child is an intimidation for him. So he destroys that cub, kills it, and go and mates with the female lion, so he can have dominion over it. And she instantly submits. When she sees his authority, she comes down and does whatever he says. Well, the lion of the tribe of Judah came to our lives and destroyed the hand of the devil, and is now destroying every single cub that ever floated around our lives. And he killed it! Are you hearing this? He's making sure that no trait of that other lion. What did the word of God say? That the enemy is like a roaring lion. And the lion of the tribe of Judah, Jesus, hallelujah, is coming for us saying, roar! Kill the cubs, Lord. Kill them all. I don't want them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Amen.
First natural and spiritual. You see that dominating lion destroying that other lion. And sometimes one lion literally kills two or three lions. Yeah? Then he'll go and kill the rest of the cubs. And then he got all of them female lions just all up on him. That's what Jesus did to us. And we like, I love you, Jesus. We burn. Show love, you burn. When I cry, you know, I'm going to do that the other week. That's your problem. We'll talk about the same thing. Hebrews, read, finish reading that.
There is no fear in love.
There ain't no fear in love now.
But perfect love.
But what?
Perfect love.
Perfect love.
Casteth out fear.
Listen, perfect love says, I ain't got time to doubt and believe at the same time. You can't have sweet and bitter water come out the same well. You can't serve two masters. You got to kick one out and reign with one. Read.
Because fear has torment.
Fear has torment. Fear has legalism in it. Fear has format in it. Fear, and I want you to hear me. Fear has legalistic attributes in it. Fear has a timid of doing what the pastor says and not what God says. Oh, you need to hear this. Huh? In other words, you don't live righteous when the pastor's around. I'm teaching y'all this. I'm not saying that you're doing this, y'all.
Amen.
I'm teaching y'all this. You see people, they get so holy when the pastor's around. Are you hearing me?
No.
When the pastor ain't around? So timid. I see people were, they scared to live for God. Scared to express how what's going on within them. Because they're scared to get judged. That's an imprisonment with all of itself. You can't even go on ahead and live for Jesus because you're too busy living for man. Are you hearing me? I'm a man just like you. I'm human just like you. I gotta serve God just like you do. You already got enough to handle. I'm going to do what thus saith the Lord and feed you righteousness. I'm going to feed you righteousness. Are you hearing me? Whatever the Lord put into my spirit to feed you, I'm going to feed it to you. This is what he said. Now read.
He that feareth is not made perfect in love.
If you fear, you're tormented. You can't come to the perfection. You can't come to having a peaceful mind. Because there's torment there. And torment is when you have doubts. Torment is when you're timid. And timid is when you lack self-assurance. Amen. Snap out of it, y'all.
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 5. Now, hurry up, y'all. Hurry up, man. This word is good. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 5.
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 5, man. I want you to see how Jesus was made perfect. Hebrews chapter 5, verse 7 to 14. Read.
Who in the days of his flesh.
He's talking about, listen now, go ahead.
When he had offered up prayer
and
supplication.
With what?
With strong crying.
With strong crying and what?
And tears.
Unto who?
Unto him that was able to save him from death.
In other words, the perfection is, I don't want to be like this no more, Lord. Save me from me. I'm a wretch. I'm a liar. I ain't no good. I don't want to be like that no more, Lord. I want to be saved, sanctified. I want you in me. This happens every time he shows you another part about you that needs to be perfected.
Amen.
Read that again. Read it again. Read it again. Read it again.
Who in the days of his flesh.
Now listen to what he says now. In the days of his flesh now.
When he had offered up prayers and supplication.
He offered up prayers and supplication. Do you know? I want you to hear this. Do you know why Jesus always went to the wilderness? And he didn't stay in what you call his house? Or at this house? Or in John's house? Or in Peter's house? You know he stood in the wilderness when he says, "Foxes have holes, birds have nests, but the Son of Man have nowhere to lay his head." In other words, nobody can say that's the house of Jesus. Do you know why? I want you to hear what the Holy Ghost is revealing right now. Do you know why he never really had a house to go to? Hear me. I want you to hear this very closely. Because he was doing what verse 7 was saying. He was overcoming every single feeling that the flesh, the Bible says he was tempted in all points such as you and I was. That means every single day he had to go before the Father and he was doing this. Read, read.
When he had offered up
prayer. He was offering up prayer. He didn't go to his bathroom. He didn't go to his living room. He didn't go to the basement because he had none. He went to the wilderness and talked with the Father. Father, Father. Read.
And supplication.
He made supplications. Go ahead.
With strong crying.
With strong crying. You know why he had strong crying? Because he did not want to have flesh take over. How will he know how to minister to us if he don't first? The book of Hebrews says this. I want you to hear me now. I want you to hear me. Hebrews, listen, not Hebrews. Romans 6 says this now. Don't go nowhere. Just stay right there. I'm going to read it for you. Romans 6 says this now. I want you to hear me now. Hear me. He says, know ye not that so many of us, as we're baptized into Jesus Christ, were baptized into his death. We were baptized into his troubles. But in his troubles that he experienced that day, flesh was wanting to move forward in. But he didn't go to nobody's house. He went to the Father with strong crying and supplications and said, Father, Father. Read, what did he do?
With strong crying and tears.
And what?
And tears.
There was a part in the scripture he said that his tears were as drops of blood. It didn't say that they were blood. They were saying that they were that strong, dropping like blood. How he gonna bleed from his eyes? Are you hearing this? What, did Jesus bust a blood vessel with his pupil? No. No. His tears were overwhelming. You ever seen a, you cry so much and you look back, a tear is probably about that big, and you're like, wow. When it drops, it spreads, and it spreads about that big, you're like, yo, hold up. That's how Jesus' tears were. He did this because he knew. We ought to do this because we know. We don't have time to play. Because we're coming to perfection. Are you hearing me? We don't got time to lax it. We don't have time to go on that. You tell your flesh tell you, you can seek God tomorrow. No, you ain't got time. You got to seek him now. Now, the day you hear my voice, seek him now. Don't let your flesh lie to you and think, make you feel like you can go a day without talking to him. Like you can go a day without telling him about you. Like you can go a day without confessing about you.
Amen.
Don't let your flesh lie to you like that.
Amen.
Don't get robbed from your life. It's the reason why. You get told that you, oh, you're good, you can wait another day and all that. All you're doing is getting set up for flesh to talk to you loud and clear. Read, what did he do? What did he do?
Unto him that was able to save him.
He knew if I cry out unto God, he's able to deliver me from death. What death? I thank God. Who shall deliver me from the body of this death? He said, I thank God that I ain't got to do it based upon ways, but I do it with my mind. So if I serve God with my mind, then I'm good. But if I try to do it with flesh, I'm serving sin, not God. And that's what causes you to go on ahead and serve sin. Because the scripture says that which is not of faith is what? Sin. That which is not of faith, excuse me, is sin. Are you hearing me? In the name of Jesus. So if you ain't got faith, it's impossible to what? To please God. You see how the word of God wraps itself like a rope? Word for word, line upon line, precept upon precept, a little here, a little there. I'm going to show you something that the Lord showed me. How you should even go on ahead and allow people to talk to you in a negative form. Are you hearing? I want you to, come on, finish reading that. Finish reading that.
And was heard in that he feared.
And he was heard in that he what?
And that he feared.
And that he in that he, I don't want to fall in this trouble. I don't want to fall in sin. I don't want to commit sin. I don't want to do no sin. He was heard in that, and he feared. I don't want to do this no more. If I allow myself to do this, I'm going to be in sin. Listen to what God read.
Though he were a son.
Now, I want you to hear this. He knew he was a son. That's the reason why he went to his daddy. And listen to this now. Though he were a son,
Yet learned he obedience
through what?
By the things which he suffered.
By the things that he experienced. You see how God was saying earlier, I made you not to destroy you. Just because you experienced something, don't mean that you can't come to perfection. Because he learned obedience. He learned to submit himself to God. He learned that that's not what he wanted. So why even pay attention to the suggestion? Because that's not who he really is. The reason why the scripture says, though he were a son, in other words, it doesn't mean that on a natural sense. No, he was a son. He was the Son of God already. We are sons and daughters of God.
Yes.
He learned obedience through the things that he had to experience. He learned perfection. He learned perfection. Obedience and perfection run hand in hand. Read, finish reading.
And being made perfect.
And being made. Whoa. Hold on a minute. Now, how could he be perfect and he's suffering? Huh? How could he be perfect and his mind talks to him? His flesh tells his mind, look, you ain't got no food today. God ain't gonna supply your need. What he did at the mountain, he did it at those times. Get behind me. Are you hearing this? So if he's got to do it, if he did it, if our Lord and Savior had accomplished it, and he was perfect, why can't we? And the Bible says that he was wrapped in sin, flesh, just like you and I. Something's wrong. If I see perfection, if I see flesh, if I see sin in flesh, and yet perfection being demonstrated, why would God the Father waste his time sending his Son Jesus down if he knew we weren't ever going to be perfect?
That's right.
Is he a liar? Is he a liar? So when will we ever come to the point that we need to wake up to the truth? And you need to hear truth when you feel a lie. When you feel that lie lying to you, you need to hear the truth. Though he were a son, yet learned he obedience by the things which he experienced. And when he overcame them, and being made perfect, what did he do?
He became.
Now hold on a minute now. I'm sorry for stopping you right there. He wasn't the author and the finisher yet. He only became the author of life and the finisher of life when he experienced death and overcame death in his life. He wrote what you're hearing right now. He wrote it by his obedience. He wrote the avenue of salvation. He wrote the avenue of salvation by demonstration. Are you hearing this? He wrote it by being obedient. Read.
He became the author of eternal salvation.
Of what?
Eternal salvation.
Unto who?
Unto all them.
That what?
That obey him.
Unto all of us.
Amen.
That obey him. He became our eternal salvation. In other words, through Christ, we have the ability to perfect perfection, perfect holiness. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
If you think this is of your own doing, you've been deceived, because you can't do nothing without him. Are you hearing this? Read.
Called of God.
What was he?
And high priest.
He was called of God. And what?
And high priest.
Go ahead.
After the order of Melchizedek.
Now, Melchizedek is still alive today.
Oh, boy.
He ain't got no end nor beginning. So, if he was after the order of Melchizedek. Hear me. When was Christ ever born? Huh? I'm not talking about the manger. That's Jesus, the body. Huh? When did Christ ever die? Huh? So he's after the order of Melchizedek. He ain't got no beginning nor end. Woo, speak, Lord. Did you know Jesus ain't never taste no wine? What are you talking about? He went on ahead and prayed for him. Read. He said he gave it to them. Why would he take the wine when he is the wine? He's the wine of the Spirit.
First natural, then. Maybe that's too much for y'all. Come back. I'll ain't determined.
Come on and read. Finish reading.
Of whom we have many things to say.
Of whom we have many things to say, what?
And heard to be uttered.
And hard.
Heard?
Brother, what you reading? Well, heard was H-E-A-R-D. Hard, brother. Hard.
Hard to be uttered.
Hard to be uttered. Go ahead.
Seeing ye are dull of hearing.
In other words, I want to tell you more, but you're looking at me like I'm crazy.
Y'all just look at me like that.
What?
And the scripture said you were going to look at me like that. Of whom we have many things to say and hard to be uttered, seeing that you're dull of hearing. For
when for the time ye ought to be teachers.
For when the time you ought to be teaching.
Ye have need that one teach you again, which be the first principles of the oracles of God.
It be the first principles of you being taught. So in other words, get out of the realm of we having to reiterate to you the simple things that you already know. And start applying the things that you already been taught. You ain't got to be told. How many times you got to call to find out whether you can come to church or not when your baby's sick? How many times you got to call to know how long is it that you got to hold off until you can come to church after you take your antibiotic? How many times you got to be told not to go on ahead and bring food into the sanctuary, or toys into the sanctuary, or cell phones into the sanctuary? Little things like that. because they're the simple things in life. Are you hearing me? How many times do I got to tell you, don't listen to how you feel, and then you feel some kind of way, and you're like, wait a second. That feels real. You know what I'm talking about. How many know what I'm talking about? This thing feel real. I'm going to call a pastor. So why are you calling me? I just had that feeling that... Like, hello? Hello? Pat? Oh, I thought I lost reception. Oh, no, I hung up on you. Oh, stop playing, man. You play too much, man. Now, for real. And a bowl of cereal has always been talked about every Thursday night, right?
Right.
Go eat. Dad, how you make this bowl of cereal? You put the cereal in the bowl and you put the milk in it. Go grab a spoon. Really? It's done. Ding! Eat it! Oh, I can? Y'all looking at... I'm being serious. Some of the things that y'all ask me be off the chain. I'll be like, some of y'all do have great questions. I'm being serious. But it's time for us to come to perfection, y'all.
Amen.
Listen, he said this. Let us go on to the weightier matters and not leave the elementary things undone. You know what the elementary things are? The things that you always ask about. That you get bothered every 3-4 months about. Am I saved? Not saved? This is going through my mind. I don't know what's going on. It's been going on for 2 weeks. 3 weeks. You don't know how long you've been tormented, huh? You know why? Because you've been thinking about it. You put your mind on a torment instead of putting your mind on Jesus. You know why he told you to get your mind off torment? Because you can't handle it. He told you to put your mind on him. You hear me? He whose mind is stayed on God is in what?
Perfect peace.
Whoa. There goes that word, perfect again. Can you believe it? What's amazing. Perfect peace. Read now. We ain't done.
And are become such as have need of milk.
You, in other words, oh, are you hearing me? In other words, we got to go back and reiterate the simple things again. We ain't going to do that now. We ain't going to do that now. Right, church?
Amen.
Amen. Got to remind you to take a shower?
Amen.
Huh? Now, why is it that when I tell y'all, I ain't got to remind you to take a shower? Some of y'all look at me. Ew. Are you getting this look? You know why I tell you I ain't got to remind you to take a shower? In other words, I'm always reminding you to seek God. I'm always reminding you to take a shower. I ain't got to remind you to take a shower. See, nothing natural. Ew. Well, how come you don't think that way about your spirit man? If you don't take a shower spiritually, you're going to stink, y'all. I ain't got to remind you to take a shower, right? Huh? I ain't got to remind you to seek the Lord, right? Huh? You got to come to perfection. Stop allowing yourself to stay in the dungeons in your mind. You need to come out that stupidity, y'all.
Amen.
It ain't even worth you handling that. Read, finish reading that.
And not of strong meat.
Go ahead.
For everyone that useth milk is unskillful in the word of righteousness.
For
saying you don't even know what you're talking about. Read.
But strong meat.
Strong meat now.
Belongs
understanding.
To
them. Listen now. Listen to what he says now. I want you to hear this very closely. Please. Please. Hear me out. Hear me out. You need to hear this very closely. You can't expect to just go on ahead and just keep getting good news, 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 and you get hype, 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 and you don't get no strong meat.
Amen.
That meat is the substance that keeps you full continually. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
You need to hear me. You need to hear me. Because the trouble didn't leave yet. The trouble didn't leave yet. It's still there.
Amen.
It's still there. You ask the same question, how do I overcome this? And when you get taught it, you don't do nothing about it. You stay stagnant. Because the same qualities of how you used to handle it is still lingering around. It's still lingering around, and you don't do nothing to change it. But you can't do nothing to complain about it, because you ain't doing nothing to change it. He said, "We read that verse again."
But strong meat.
No, the other one before that.
For everyone that useth milk, is unskillful in the word of righteousness.
In other words, you don't know how to impart what you need to move forward in life. The doctrine teaches you how to stay. Gospel keeps you encouraged.
Amen.
It's time for us to go on to the weightier matters. Go on into perfection. I'm going to show you this. Come on and read.
But strong meat belongeth to them that are of full age.
Even
those who by reason
of use have what?
Have their senses exercised.
In other words, to what?
To discern both good and evil.
Now, the ones that want to be encouraged constantly, 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 keep falling for the same old, same old, same old, those are the ones that want the milk. Hear me. The word of God is saying those are the ones that want the milk. The doctrine seems to be too challenging for me to do. Because I get taught the same old, same old, same old. But those that want meat are those that by use of the discernment, in other words, they get taught what's right and what's wrong and grow thereby. Those are the ones that are going unto perfection. Some of you in here, male and female, got decisions to make. Some of you in here, male and female, have decisions to make. You still didn't make up your mind, because the old you is still around. God is saying, drop that bad habit. And stop falling into the groove of the same old, same old. You gotta want Jesus more than what you see yourself living in. Not all, but some of you's in here. Still, you gotta make up your mind. You gotta make up your mind, male and female. You got to make up your mind. You got good days, bad days. More bad days than good days. Good days, slow days. Good days, no days. Bad days, all day. That has to stop. You got to drop that part about you. You got to say, that's it. I'm done living for me. I'm going to live for the Lord.
Listen to what he says now. But strong meat belongeth to them that are full age, even those who by reason of use, they use the meat, have their senses, have their spiritual discernment exercised to discern both good and evil. In other words, they know within themselves who they are, and they know outside themselves who they are too. So it's not a challenge for them to go on ahead and say, I'm not going to listen to my outer man, because inside of me there's a love for God and I got to move forward. So if I move forward, that means that I got to learn to discipline myself.
Amen.
You ain't going to discipline yourself, still falling into the same old, same old.
Amen.
You got to do the opposite of what you have found yourself to be like.
Amen.
You know what that means? Even if you got to wake up early in the morning and seek the Lord.
Amen.
We got to get out of the realm of living by flesh, y'all. That's not helping us. That's not helping you. That's imprisoning you. It's making it hard for you to live for Christ. There's no peace in flesh, y'all. Listen. Listen. I want you to see this. The scripture says that he, read, come on. Oh, that's the verse 14. Perfection. Perfection is obedience. In obedience, I want you to hear this. Write this thing down. Hurry up. We're about to get about it in a few. Obedience. And I'd love to get back to this if the Lord says the same. Obedience means to heed. Heed. When you heed, you don't do the same things you used to do. You can't cry. You want to be out of, you want to have a changed life. You want this, you want that, and you don't do nothing to make the change.
Amen.
You can't cry about what you're in if you don't do nothing to get out. What's the sense of knowing the way if you don't even use the way? To what purpose, what gain is it for you to have been taught how to get to where you need to be and you discard it? Stop treating yourself raw and come to the obedience. Stop letting those demons talk to you. Put those liars under subjection. Stop asking to get hyped up, to get encouraged out of how your flesh makes you feel. That realm of torment.
Amen.
You're only tormenting yourself, making way for you to feel yourself. You're all in yourself. Can't even get out of yourself. Because you're so into yourself. That's bad. Some of you, male and female, are caught up in that. It's time for you to let it go. Some of you youth are involved in that too. If not, I dare say almost 80% of the youth are like that. Don't do nothing. You got to come to the understanding that around you ain't nothing good. You got to come to the understanding that your flesh, how you feel, ain't nothing ever good. When your flesh makes you feel anything to the negative, you gotta let it go.
Amen.
Throw it away. They're just wasting your time. You're like a dog chasing its own tail. You ain't going nowhere. And then your flesh tells you to give it on up. Stop going to church. You see what happens when you make place for your flesh to talk to you? Let it go. It's time for you to be free. Amen. It's time for you to be free. God is pleading with you. God is reasoning with you.
tribal man always. I'm not a tribal man always. I'm not going to wrestle with you to serve me, he's saying. I'm not going to fight you to serve me. You either serve me with all your heart and all your soul and all your strength. If not, you put yourself in torment. Shut up. When judgment day comes, you must understand that if you don't make the effort now, where he finds you when he cracks that cloud, he's going to bind you.
Amen.
Listen to what he says now. I want you to hear this. Obedience is to heed or conform to a command. That's what obedience is. Some of us are not obedient. We cry about not, I don't want to be like this no more. Well, what are you doing to change? Nothing. Nothing. You can't cry about a change and still be the same. You got to stop tormenting yourself in that fashion.
Amen.
Are you hearing this?
Amen.
When God has made you better than what you view yourself to be, you got to say to yourself and know within yourself, I deserve a better life. And it's only in Christ. And I'm willing to give everything up for the sake of living for him. That's the mindset you got to come to. But if you don't feel you're worthy of it, then knock yourself out with your feelings. But how is it that you can feel one way and God says that you're supposed to be another way? Who are you going to believe, the way you feel or what God said? That's the kicker. Because if your feelings can sway you to override the word of God, then you have surrendered to sin. Are you hearing me? And God is saying, my son did not die at the cross for you to stay in the condition that you're in.
Amen.
Are you hearing this?
Amen.
Stop living a lie and come to the truth. Listen. Obedience means to heed or conform to a command or authority. It means being obedient to you're attentive. You're attentive. Attentive. You're hearkening. When you're hearkening, your mind, you ain't looking all over the church. You ain't worried about what people say. You ain't holding conversations from the back to the front, from the front to the back, from side to side. When you're hearkening, you ain't falling asleep. When you want to change, when the word of God is interesting to you, you ain't going to fall asleep. When you're interested in something, okay, how tired you are. Tired, leave. And you stay attentive. Somebody tell you they're going to give you $1 million right now. Tiredness leaves out the window. You're automatically thinking about what you always wanted to buy. So now you make a plan. You're staying up all night. I'm going to buy this. I'm going to buy that. I'm going to buy this. I'm going to buy that. You know, I'm tired. I ain't tired at all. Why don't you do that for the word of God, who's going to promise you a new world to come? And you sleep in the sanctuary. You shouldn't cry over things that you're doing to yourself. Hey, do you know what? The enemy ain't even doing it to you. You're doing it to yourself. Mm-hmm.
definition of perfect. Perfect means to complete. Whoa. To complete. You stop smoking, right? You perfected that. You stop drinking, right? You perfected that. Huh? Right? Right? You stop clubbing, right? You perfected that. Right? Huh? You stop lying, right? You perfected that. Right? You start working hard for your money, right? You perfected that. You're not going to sell drugs no more. Huh? You stop whoremongering around. You perfected that. Huh? Are you hearing this? There's many things that you perfected. Whatever God brought you through and you overcame, you perfected that. Because the definition for perfect means to complete. That is to literally accomplish. You literally accomplished. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
To consummate. Or am I saying that right? Consummate. C-O-N-S-U-M-M-A-T-E. Consummate in character, to fulfill. Do you know what the word consummate means? To bring to a state of perfection. You ain't got no business griping about what the Lord has delivered you from. You ought to rejoice and be happy that God is perfecting your lives. It means, to consummate means to bring to a state of perfection, to complete an arrangement. To complete an arrangement. It's an agreement by a pledge or the signing of a contract. In other words, I agree to do my part if you agree to do your part. Huh? When you gave your life to Jesus Christ, you saying, I'm agreeing to uphold your word if you agree to be my Lord. I'll agree to demonstrate your truth if you agree to be my truth. Are you hearing this? I got so much to give you. Ooh, I got so much to give you. I got to teach some more to you about timidness, fear. Ooh, I'm talking about, listen, and then there's other parts where he's going to talk to you about the circumcision of the heart. He's going to show you how your heart gets circumcised to perfection. I'm going to leave that alone. It's amazing, y'all. Y'all look like y'all not sure. You're like, look. We are on the verge of growth. We've come through numerous troubles. God has brought us from a mighty long way.
Amen.
We've come through some tough times. Times where it almost seemed like it would have been better for you to throw in the towel. But you still held on. Are you hearing this? God has been with us all this time. He made his contract. I'll never leave you. Neither will I forsake you. He reinstated it. He said, I'll be there. Even before you call, I'm going to be there. ever look at. He never will either.
Amen.
Because he's God. Are you hearing it? How many are glad?
Amen.
How many are glad? Let me share this with y'all. I want to share this with you. I know who's feeling flesh. I know who's feeling flesh. I know. Because God's showing me. And I know who's receiving word. Because God is showing me. I know who's allowing confusion to linger. Because God is showing me. And I know who's ready to move up. Because God is showing me. I know who's tormented. And I even know what you're tormented about. You have less battles about you. You have less battles in you. You have less battles against you. You can't lose serving God his ways. But you will lose trying to serve God your way. You'll learn. Let's pray. Bow your heads. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, I did exactly what you told me to do. I thank you, Lord, for the word that you've given us tonight. Father, I ask of you, Lord, those that received, Lord. Those that didn't. Lord, I ask that you put such trouble in their lives that they'll quit sin. Father, I speak it into existence unto those who find it hard. Bring them to the point of saying, I give and I surrender. Father, I ask these blessings, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Cause there to be a surrenderance. Cause there to be, Lord, a giving up. Those that have surrendered, cause there, Lord, to be an uplifting. Father, that both, those that surrendered and those that find it challenging, may be of the same level, according to your will, that we'll be careful to give you the glory, the honor, and the praises. Precious Lord, I know you're able to do it. You're able to do it. And with you, nothing is impossible. Father, I count it done, even now, in Jesus' mighty name. Not that I may be glorified, but that your name may be great in our very lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Amen. Amen. I want to tell you, get ready. Get ready. Get ready. Because trouble is on its way. Amen. Scared. Come on, give God some praise.
first, which is this Saturday, and I have the form up here for the parents to come and sign their children. And it says, and the youth department is asking everyone for can and bottle donations. Please bring your cans and bottles to help support our up and coming trip. We will be collecting all donations from now until Monday, April. Also tomorrow is